We're talking about airline delays, TSA problems, lines, etc. We've got Gordon Bethune and Seth Kaplan. Guys, thank you for being so patient through that. Seth Kaplan, here's the problem. We all complain about the lines at the TSA and at the airport, etc., but we also want to be safe. We don't want to compromise safety. Is the TSA, and I'm going to defend the TSA, stuck in an impossible-to-win position?
Not at all. You know, around the world, one thing that's very different is that other security regimes, a lot of them handled by contractors, some not, have customer service standards. And you could go to some of the busiest airports in the world, Brian. You know, London Heathrow, you get through in 10 minutes. And that's because it's in the contract that, you know, the contractor has to process whatever, you know, 90% of people in 10 minutes or less, or they get fined or fired. So, and they do a good job. But we could use some of that here. No question, they've kept us very safe. But it's just a huge drain on productivity in this country. You tell everybody they got to be at the airport 2 hours before a flight.
Right. Gordon, you know, we want to travel. We don't want to wait on long lines. We want to be safe. And we also want to have a cheap ticket. Who ultimately, I mean, if we're going to look at technological solutions to upgrade the experience and expedite lines, who ultimately would pay for that? Would it be the passengers at the end of the day?
Sure, they just enacted not that long ago another tax increase on every ticket for security, but that money went to the general fund and not to the TSA. So they're getting the money from the passengers today, but they're not delivering the product as was just mentioned. I think it's an allocation of resources, a lot of administrative overhead in the TSA. You could, like some police departments, put more people on the street. It just depends upon how you allocate those resources.
Gordon, answer a question that I've got personally, because I fly into a lot of very small airports. And this is true. I have actually literally been to airports where there are more TSA workers than there are people on the plane. Then you go to a huge airport and you seemingly can't find somebody. Why does that happen? Because you talk about misallocation of resources. What the heck is going on?
Well, it's mismanagement, Brian. I mean, you don't put the people where the passengers are the security agents. And so they don't run part-time jobs. They're eight-hour shifts, even though there's one or two people in the Kalispell. When you go into Chicago, there's people there all the time, day and night. So I did say there was an allocation of resource problem. That's a management problem. And they could do more to make sure that the agents are where the people traveling are at the time they want to travel.
All right, guys, we're going to leave it there. Thanks so much, Gordon Bethune and Seth Kaplan. Michelle.
Thanks, Melissa.